It is 7:41 Kai FM 95.9. Good Friday, Skhumba, Ndumiso. Time for you, Blom Blom. Yes, leading up to the elections, we decided that we're going to invite a few political parties to come and have a chat to us. Ndumiso, we are choosing a president.
Yeah.
So we need to know who do you want to choose and all. And at the same time, we need to understand if Labantu Skhumba Votel have a lighter side of life. So we decided we want to start this one with the leader of the APC. Yes, that is Mr. Themba Godi. Themba Godi is the African People's Convention. Is in parliament.
Yeah, yeah. National Assembly.
Yeah, no.
We're chairman of an entire parliamentary committee.
Can you imagine, Joe? We have the whole chairman here. Yeah. chilling with us there. Mr. Themba Godi, welcome, Kazlam. How are you, sir?
Thanks very much. I'm happy to be here.
Are you happy to be here?
Actually, no.
Why? I could tell. Nyakubona ngathi awukho mnandi.
We are regret.
Well, yeah, no. You always very entertaining watching you, but being here, I now understand what other people go through.
it's nothing. I wanted to find out, okay, since we're looking at 8 Zagame, they're coming. Chances are you might be our president after 8 Zagame. There's a good chance that you might be the president. But we don't know, Brad Themba. We don't know. Like, all we know from you is what we read, that we went, you come from Pushpak Ridge in Mpumalanga. So tell us, how did it come about for you to be a politician coming from Pushpak Ridge? Can you imagine Pushpak Ridge? Could have been a striker for the Black Leopards, Mos.
Well, actually, it was that very fact of being in the rural areas that actually prompted me a great deal. Way back in the early 80s, I had a sense that our people in the rural areas were not that very active in the struggle. And yet, post-liberation, there will be an expectation on their part that, they should have a central role, and I felt it was important to do so. So when I was at high school, around 83, we came together and started a political party. Mm-hmm. But of course, I joined the PAC a year later in 1984, just before I went to varsity.
You know, whenever one sees you on TV, and this is the difference, right? You always strike one as someone who's extremely calm, and you are so unassuming. T-shirt, you hardly ever wear a suit and a tie. But I remember once listening to you because someone had not honored appearance in front of his scoper, and I could hear a bit of anger. Have you ever been like really, really frustrated to the point where you lost it? Because you don't seem like the type.
Well, it takes a lot to get me there. I actually don't like emotions, whether it's excitement or anger. I always operate on the rational side.
Yeah.
And I always try, with the ambition of being the president of the country, you must always keep your head up and not be overcome by, by feelings of emotion. So it takes really quite a lot for somebody to get me, on the other side. But I always try to keep a balance.
Yeah. I've seen on TV, I'm like, he knows what he wants. But I wanna know, like, if not politics, Bozo Yenzan. If not politics, what were you gonna be, Joe?
Well, growing up like all African kids, I used to play soccer. I had a mini.
I knew.
When I was at varsity, I was a goalkeeper.
Yeah.
And, when I started working, I had to decide. And I remember that painful day when I had to give away my soccer boots because I realized that there was a clash between my political work and
your goalkeeping duties.
Because on Saturdays I must go play soccer, but that's the time when I must go and attend meetings. But I was a teacher by profession. I enjoyed my job, as I always try to enjoy anything that I do. I really am not sure if I could have been anything other than what I am.
Wow, that's actually quite interesting. Now, you come from a party, EPAC. glorious history. Yesterday, a lot of people don't like to talk about the fact with the 21st of March, what is now called Human Rights Day, what some of us call Sharpeville Day, was really rooted in the politics of the PAC. You look at the PAC, manje. So there is a PAC, there is yourselves who fragmented in Nenza, in the APC, there are other people. What do you think of just the state of Pan-Africanism in our political sphere, manje?
Well, look, I grew up in the PAC. I'm what I am because of the PAC. And that's why I've never insulted and will never insult the PAC.
Yeah.
I still consider it my home.
Mm.
But, you know, when we left to form the APC, it was precisely to preserve the legacy of the PAC.
Yeah.
To say if the PAC decides to die, at least its legacy should be preserved so that you don't have the revisionism that the ANC engages in of trying to whitewash everybody else except themselves. Now, we are building the APC to be the torchbearer of Pan-Africanism. And I think having played a patient game, 11, 12 years later, we are satisfied that we have laid a solid foundation to build an organization that will raise the flag of Pan-Africanism high in our country.